All right, so the next thing we're gonna do is filter our search results that users are searching for based on the date range. So we've already built in filtering based on the city and the number of guests, but now what we wanna do is only show homes that are available during the search range that someone chooses. So here on our homepage, we've built out this search bar and we have this date range. So what we wanna do is, just as an example, let's say someone searches for March 1st to March 5th. If a home is not available on March 3rd, but it is available on the other dates, we still don't want to show that home in the results because this person is looking for a specific range of dates. So let's go back to our search results page, and I'm going to walk you through how to do this. It is a little bit tricky in Bubble to kind of work with these date ranges and work with the overlapping date ranges. So I'm gonna try and explain it as slowly and concisely as I can. So here, let's double click on the repeating group. And the first thing we wanna do is go ahead and add a custom state to this repeating group. And to do this, we're gonna go ahead and click that little icon there, the I, and we're gonna add a custom state to the repeating group. So to add this, we're gonna go ahead and name it date range. And let's just go ahead and call it a date range and go ahead and click create. So we have a custom state called date range, which is a date range. And the reason we're doing this is it's going to be easier to call that date range in our search results as opposed to having to build out, get the date ranges from the URL parameters when we're gonna have to call it multiple times. You'll see as we kind of keep going why this is helpful. So I'm gonna go ahead and exit out. And then what we need to do is go to our workflows and go ahead and I want you to go and click here to add a new event. And it's gonna be when the page is loaded. And I already have this one here, but I'm gonna go ahead and delete the one that I created. So when page is loaded, what we're going to do is go to our element actions and we're going to set a state. The element is the repeating group home because that's where we created that custom state. And then the custom state is the date range. And then the value is going to be to get data from the page URL. And the parameter is check-in. That's the name of that parameter that we created in that back when we first created the search bar on the homepage, and it's a date, and close that, and then we're gonna do a range, and then we're gonna get data from page URL again, and check out, and it is a date. And I'm gonna go ahead and close that. So now, every time the page is loading, we're gonna set the state of that date, of that repeating group with this date range that the user searched for. So I'm gonna go ahead and exit out. And I'm just going to quickly just remind you on the index page in this workflow, when we click and we go to the search results page, this is where we have the check-in and check-out parameters. And you have to make sure that when you're calling it on the search results page that you're matching it exactly here. Okay, so let's go back to our designer. Let's go to our search results page. And now double-click on your repeating group home. So here we have our data source, search for homes. And if I go ahead and click on that, we've already added constraints for address and guests. And you might think we could just add more constraints for our search dates, but it doesn't work that way. That won't work. Bubble doesn't give you the ability to filter out date ranges in that way. So what we need to do is go ahead and click more. And then search for filtered. So what we're gonna do is create a filter on that result. And go ahead and click add a new constraint, and then go down to advanced. We're gonna do an advanced filter. And we're gonna say this home's booked dates. So this home, it's gonna mean go through each cell here. So this home's booked dates, this is a list of date ranges that we created before, which we're adding the list of date ranges whenever a home is booked. So we're this home's booked dates. And then what we're gonna do is type filter again, and we're gonna filter the booked dates. And what we're gonna do is add a constraint, and it's going to be where this date range And then it's going to say overlaps with. And then what we're going to do is the repeating group homes date range. And that's that custom state that we just created. So the constraint is where it overlaps. And then we're going to close that out. And then we're back here. And then we're going to do each item is empty. So we're going to look for each item here. It's going to search for each item. It's empty. And then what we want to do is say count is zero. So basically, what this is searching for is first we're going to look for this home's booked dates, and then we're going to filter those where the booked dates matches overlaps with the date range that was searched. Then we want to see where each one of those, the result is empty, and we're going to count to zero. So we count zero means it is empty. And go ahead and close. And there we go. So that works. And now let's go and we're going to do it one more time on the map because we need the filter to. So go ahead and double click on your map. And we're just going to go through one more time. So we're going to search for homes. And it's going to be the exact same thing. We're going to filter. And we're going to go ahead and add a new constraint. And it's an advanced search. And it's where this home's booked dates. And we want to say another filter here. And on this filter, we're going to say this date range overlaps with the repeating group's home's date range. And close that. And then each item is empty. Count is zero. So the same exact formula there. So let's go ahead and close it. And let's go ahead and test it out. So if we go to our data and we go to our homes and we go to our app data, sorry, and our homes, we can see here that we have one home with a book date of March 15th to 17th. So let's go ahead and preview. And let's just go to our home page where we're going to do a search. So this home is in New York with three guests. And then we're going to go ahead and search for a date range. So first, let's do the first through the fourth just to confirm that this is working. So here we go. It is working. The map is showing up. And that's all working as expected. So let's go back and we'll do New York again, three guests. And now let's do the 13th through the 15th. So the home is not available on the 15th because it's booked through the 15th, 16th, and 17th. So let's search. This should not show up, and it does not. And we'll go back and refresh. And let's do one more here. And let's just go ahead and do the 21st through the 31st and search again. And it's showing up. So now it is all working correctly. And one other thing to keep in mind while you are on your test version of Bubble and you haven't entered in the Google Maps API key for yourself yet. You'll get rate limited sometimes and the map won't show up, but just kind of keep that in mind. And if you give it some time, it'll show up again. And you can also enter in your own Google Maps API key, for that as well.